You're welcome to the 8th class of this application development session with Apidom code. My name is Anuprata Sarkar and I am from Alipurdwar, West Bengal. I'm 11 years old and I'm a coder and I'm an instructor for the day. Today we are going to start a very interesting topic, Android Studio. Many of you have heard the name Android app development. So we were developing apps. Yeah, we were developing apps. That's true. But let's do something tricky. Android Studio has two languages, Java and Kotlin. It's a very popular platform for developing apps. I mean, we are just going to continue with Android Studio Thunderbolt. We are just going to do random classes like my previous classes were, one class for Scratch and others for Blockly. So this classes I have done till 7th. So I have continued Blockly. So I will continue Blockly again because this is the first Android Studio video. I will continue Blockly again. The next class can be Blockly. The 9th class can be Blockly. That's not sure as because I will do something like that. I will do randomly. Some days web development, some days Android Studio. And that's real learning. So that will be fun. So now let's start. Firstly, what is Android Studio? Android Studio is a platform where you can code. Just like Thunderbolt, but it's more difficult than Thunderbolt or something like that. It's not Blockly. It's Java and Kotlin, two brand new languages. So, mainly in this app development session, we are going to learn Java. Yeah, we will learn Kotlin too, but that will be later. Now we will learn Java. Okay. As we know, we have heard the name of Java, I think. Java is a very popular language. Let me search on Google about Java. Who is the developer? Let's see. James Bodling is the developer of this language. So I don't keep information related to who designed it and when it appeared. So you can see Java is a high-level, class-based, object-oriented programming language that is designed to have as few implementation dependencies as possible. So here, there are two types of coding in Java. One is coding through Oracle and one is Android Studio. So in Android Studio, we can make apps, Android app development. So we are going to start with Android Studio. So firstly, it's Android Studio installation. I already have Android Studio. I'm just going to guide you through the process. Firstly, let's open our Google or any other browser you are using. I'm not recommending any. Let's search Android Studio install. Can see install Android Studio for C, developer.android.com Android Studio install. Click on this. It's loading. So it's taking you to this. You can click on download Android Studio and then you don't need to read all these things because these are fine. Okay, so let's scroll down and then let's click on I have read and agree with the above terms and conditions and download for Windows. So I'm not going to download, you just click on save and then it is going to be running because I have already installed Android Studio. And you know friends, Android Studio installation, it is, you can see 912 MBs. Actually, this needs a very fast internet connection. If you have a slow internet connection, it can take up to 2 hours or 1 hour, let's say. If you have a fast internet connection like my internet connection when I have installed Android Studio, I think it took about 3 minutes. It was very fast. It was too fast. So you need to have a fast internet connection. If you don't have a fast internet connection, don't worry. Just take your laptop. So Android Studio is not available on mobile as you can't code such large apps in mobile. And coding is not possible in mobile. Let's download Android Studio in a laptop. So we will open our laptop and we will go and search Android Studio installation and we will come to this website and we will click on download Android Studio. We will not read those things. We'll click on I have read and agree with the above terms and conditions. Let's click on download and we will click on save there and it will be installed. You can see, you'll be able to see in the top, in the bottom left corner here. I hope you can see my arrow. Like this one box comes. Let me show you. Let's search birds images. It's beautiful. Let's download this one. You will click on right click and you will click on, that's not necessary. I'm just showing you. When you are downloading something, it's showing in the bottom left corner. You don't need to download that and waste your storage. Let me delete that from here too. So like this, here comes a box in the bottom left, which shows it's downloading. So it will show its speed. If you have a Windows 64-bit, you can install from here. If you don't have it, you can download options and you'll be able to see. For it's 912 MBs for Windows 64-bit. Scroll down, it's for Mac. If you're on Mac, you can use this. But I think most of them have Windows as it is popular from before. This is Mac. Linux 64-bit, Chrome operating system. You can download it according to your operating system choice and 64-bit or 32-bit. Okay. So after downloading Android Studio, that's done. So I have already downloaded Android Studio. Let's open it. So I have worked on many projects here actually. So today we will start from a very new project. Today, we are going to experience some elements basically. The most basic elements which we are going to learn today. Here are many apps created by me in Android Studio. So I've worked on Android Studio. So I want to create new project, create your own project. They will tell you to select a project template. No, we are not going to go with templates because we are going to go with empty activity. This is an empty activity. Click on this, double click on this, or simply click, single click on this and click on next. Here, the name is written my application. Okay, so today I'm going to name it Apidom. Spaces are not allowed. I think they are allowed here. Okay, I prefer to use underscores. Okay, Apidom coding class, which one? 8, I think. Yeah, 8. So now here's package name, which will automatically decide Anup Brother, which is my name. So this is basically like that com.developerName.appsName or com.companiesName.appsName, which decides the package name. Let me go to Google Play Store and show you some package names. So this concept will be clear to you. Let's open the store. Let me go to apps. Okay. So, which one is your favorite? Let's say Amazon because it's popping up and I like it. Here you can see in ID is in.amazon.mshop.android.shopping. This is the package name. Click on Instagram. It's com.instagram.android. These are the package names, different package names. Go to Messenger. You can see com.facebook.org because Messenger is an app of Facebook. So, they have named it like that. Let's open Duolingo. com.duolingo and nothing else. Okay, so these are the package names. So let me go to one of my apps. This is Apidom Trivia. Let me open it. com.anupratha.apidom.trivia. So I have developed this app on my own. So I have named it. This is from Android Studio. com.anupratha, which is my name, but Apidom Trivia, which is the app's name. So firstly, it will take our name. So as I have already logged in, it will take my name. You can change it here once. Suppose it shows com.android. Just if your name is, let's say, Arab. Let's name it Arab. So my name is Anupratha, so I'm named Anupratha. Or if you have any company, suppose my company, they just tap down. If my company is developing an app and I want to change the package name, I can do it like com.apidom.apidom. So I prefer Anupratha as it's my name and I'm developing it on my own. So after that, choose your language. There are two languages, Java and Kotlin. Java is the most popular one and we are going to start with that. Use Java. And this is the minimum SDK version. You can see SDK 16. Android 4.1, the name is Jelly Bean, 17, 18, like that. It depends on. Okay, so when the API increases, like API 18, API 19 is more developed than API 8. But the problem is that when we click go on API 19, GitCap, it runs on less devices. And when we go on API 16, It runs on 99.8% devices, which is much more than API 19.20. So here we are not using any advanced things. So we are gonna run on API 16, which will run on most of the devices. Okay. So I think now our devices, most of the devices run on, I think, Oreo and Pi, which are the most popular. Oreo, Pi, and some NOUGAT, I can spell that. Okay. API 16, Android 4.1, Jelly, and nothing else. Click on finish. I hope you understood. It's initializing our project. Let it update what indices. Okay, so let it update that and let it load everything. Then we will click on zoom, else it will hang. Let it do the Gradle build. After that, we will click on zoom. Nothing will happen if you click on zoom from before. Let me click on zoom now. Okay, it's configuring Gradle. Oh, how much time it's going to take? Yeah, running apps on Android Studio is very difficult. As you can see, the code you can see it here. It's much more harder than blocky code. Put activity main, and here are the three things. Here for designing for the elements to drag and drop, we have to code also. Let's click on. You can see the three. Hierarchy, you can see code split. What does code means? You have to design by code. What does split means? You can see this thing, what's happening, and you can code. And you can click on design, where you have to drag and drop the elements. So I prefer split. Okay. So before starting, this shows us constraint layer. So we are going to make our app on linear layout, which will align it from top to bottom vertically. So you don't need to think about it. Just go and present your XML Android on the next line and remove this constraint and write linear layout here. Linear layout. And here it will show red. Click on here. Remove this. Click on backspace. Open angle bracket and click on slash. It will automatically detect that it is a linear layout. Set the orientation. How will it align horizontally or vertically? The orientation to vertical. So nothing will be there. Let's remove this text. We don't know what is text. Let's start. So let's start with a basic text view. Let's go to design. Let's go to split, because we will not write. Start the angle bracket and click on text view. So this is much like the label in Thunkable. So the height. So the width to match pattern and the height to wrap content. Okay. And then click on slash, it will close the angle bracket. Here, write text and choose this option. So what can be the text here? Hello, I'm a brother. Hello, I am a brother. You can see the text. Okay, much like the Thunkable, we can design here too. So it's telling us to convert this to a, I will teach that to you later. Let's go to the next slide. Okay, how to design that? How can we bring this to the center? Yeah, we can. Text align, we can write text alignment and click on this and we can the center. You can see our text is aligned at the center. Let's see what's the error. Okay. Text alignment is not available for API 16. As I told, advanced tools are not available for API 16. So what are we going to do here to run on most of the devices? We are going to choose gravity. I think you have heard about gravity. When an apple falls down, it falls down at the bottom. Why? Down. Because the gravity is pulling it downwards. Here, my gravity inside the app will pull this text to center. Let's set the gravity to center. So it's pulling the text towards the center. Okay. So you can see, hello, I'm Anupra. Can we increase the text size here? Text size. Here's got font size, here's text size. So the text size here is measured in SP. Like in Thunkable, we just write text size is 18. We have to write 18 SP. Let's see what's 18 SP. Yeah, our text size is increasing. Now let's say 50 SP. Yeah, it's so big that it will eat me now. So let's set it to a moderate size, 30 SP. It's looking much more good now. Okay, so let's change the text color. Let's set the text color to purple 700. That's looking good. Let's set it to teal 200. You can see now. We can change the color from here. You can see here color slash. There's no color code here, you will see. No, we can enter color codes too here. Why is the color slash? Let's see. Let's open this rest. I hope you're understanding. Let's open this rest and let's open this values and go to colors. So what color we are using? Purple 700. You can see here, purple 700 in one color code. That's happening inside that. Everything has a reason. In this world, everything has a reason. Nothing is without a reason. Reasoning is main thing here. Why is it happening here? Why is this color slash purple 700? You can see the color code also here. As 3700B3. Let's go to purple 700. I think the color code is not the same here. But you can see from, I think we changed the color code. But that doesn't matter. From where does this come? This purple 700 from this color. That's why we say that add the red color, because it's inside the race. It's inside the race and it's inside the values and colors. So only for colors, not for any other thing. It's add the red strings. But when it is inside values, we will tell that add the red that thing. Suppose we are getting something from the strings. Let's say, let's go to strings. You can see string name, app name. This app name is Apidom coding plus A. Okay. So how can we name this directly as Apidom coding? What? Apidom coding plus A. Yeah. Without changing anything. It's in the strings folder. So type here add the red string slash app. Apidom coding class A. Simple. I'm changing it here. From here the color comes. So let me introduce you to a special tool. HTML color codes. This thing, oh my god, this thing helps us to choose a color and gives us the color code. You can see here, you can choose like this, you can take the color code. But here one awesome feature is that it gives a palette like this. What color of the text do you want here? I don't have a good color choice, I'm telling you from before. Okay, so this is good, I think. This is good. So we can directly go here, and we can cut this and we can write hash this. You can see the color is changing. But how to do that alternate color slash? Let's go to colors and press enter, right? Color name is equal to my blue text color. C-O-L-O-U-R. Here they are writing C-O-L-O-R as there, as it is American English. Let's close the angle bracket and it automatically gives us slash color. And what I was telling color, that's of American English. I say in India, so I use English CB, which is English Great Britain, I think. Yeah, that uses C-O-L-O-U-R. That's the correct English. So let's enter the same color code here. And instead of this now, we can write add the red color slash, let me see what's the color name, my blue text color. Now, instead of, if you are doing a project of 1000 text views, instead of pasting that, the color code again and again, you can write this thing. Add red color slash my blue text color. That's Android Studio. It's very interesting. So here, today we are learning text. Okay, so let me check the properties of text which I can teach you today. Yeah, let's make it bold. How to make it bold? Here you can write text style. You can see it's much bolder than before. Okay. How to do bold? Okay. We can delete this bold and we can do this neatly. It's like slanting like that. Okay. So if we want to do bold and neatly, same red, we can, if you want to do bold and italic together, what to do? Firstly, let's type bold, and you can see how to show you the key. Let me open the keyboard here, not that one, on screen keyboard. Let me show you. Here's your keyboard. You can see the keyboard here. We'll press shift, and this thing will give you this sign. It's written this time here, like slash, you can see on your keyboard. I can also see on my keyboard. In your normal keyboard, you will see it below backspace, I think. Yeah, you can see something like this backward slash. At the top of it, you can see something straight. So we need that straight line. You can shift and click on this, that left slash. You will get that straight line. So I hope you have understood by now. Just click on shift all together with that left slash. You can see here, let's press it here. Now you can see it's slanting as well as it's bold. Okay, let's style it like that. Okay. So like this, we are making this here like that. Okay. So how to code it? Let's say when this text will be pressed, it will say that I am pressed. How? So now when we run this app, let's run this. I think I will need a mobile phone for that. Okay, I'm bringing it right here. AI right where I bought my emulator, the mobile phone, and connected it with this USB wire. I think it's the charger's wire which will be available easily at home. Let me read it. Yeah, this one. You can see this USB wire. Something which is connected to this charger like that, and you can use it for charging phones. Let me set this here. Let me connect this long wire to the computer. I hope you know this process. And let me connect this to mobile. Okay. So it's connected. Now, what I will do is, you can see physical device. It's loading the physical device. What's the physical device? It's Samsung SM-GSX-10F. So firstly, it will not come like that. You'll go to settings and you have to open developer options and you have to enable this. For this, when you'll be doing this at, for the first time, you will get a pop-up notification. Do not overlook it. Press OK and your device will be accepted. If you have failed to do this, you can write on the you can write on the comment section in Apidom coding or in this video comment section, or you can see other videos of how to connect USB wire with this laptop and get this user developer settings, which is something else. You can write there Android Studio, how to connect this to Android Studio and make it that. Okay, so firstly, I will do one thing. I will press this one button. It's gradable, it's running. You can see here, gradable is running. Let me show the status. Oh. How much time will it take? I don't know. It is spawning. It's installing in my device. I'll show you once it is installed. Okay, it's taking a long time. Once it is installed, we can open this USB wire. You can see here the class name, Apidom Coding Class 8, I think. You're able to see. Oh, my image is mirrored. let me set the settings to let me not win on my video. Okay. Hope you'll be able to see now. Yeah, you can see. Yes, I think you can see because I can see in my camera that you'll be able to see. Let me make this thing large. Yeah. You see it? I hope. Okay. Once this is done, you can remove the wire because we are going to do this again. So I'm connecting the wire. Then closing this app from here. Okay. So now we are going to create a special thing. When this button will be pressed, what will happen is that it will tell I am pressed. For that, you have seen what is ID in the first video. If you haven't, just go and check it. Let's set the Android ID to @ID/. Everything is available from before. @ plus ID slash TextView1. Firstly, it will be red, but when it will be done, it will show green. Means it is all right. Okay. So now we are going to Java and we are going to program. So now we are going to learn Java. A moment of excitement working on me as well. So here what we were doing till now was nothing but XML, which is used to design. It uses multiple languages to develop an app, and it takes thousands of days and millions of dollars of investment and thousands of developers to make apps like Snapchat, Instagram, Facebook, WhatsApp, and the Duolingo and those apps. Okay, press backspace and go like that. So you'll get space here. You want space and make work easier for you. That's not compulsory. You can do in a space like that. But I prefer doing like that so that much more space is available to you. And you can do field. Like private. Since it will be private, it will be limited to this only. Private. Text view. It is importing the data. Private text view, text view 1. Okay. We'll end this with a semicolon. Now, click on space here. Text view 1 is equal to find view by ID r.id dot. That's a code. You have to remember it. Friends, you know, some days before, you can say that about 4 months before, I even didn't know what's Android Studio and how to use it. I was focused on Blockly more than any other language. I started Android Studio and I felt that it is very difficult. But slowly, I learned on my own and I tried. And I just tried to develop projects on my own. And like that, after failures, I learned Android Studio and now it's fully in my mind. After some days of practice, I know fully what's Android Studio and how to use it and how to develop advanced apps in it. So you can see what's the ID, TextView1. So it will be r.id.TextView1. Now why it is, let me explain the code to you. So I have written the code so far. So you can see, private. Private means it will be limited to this main activity, which is used for this activity main, this layout. And this private TextView, which is the TextView we are using. Not this one, particularly this one, we are going to text. We are creating a text and we are naming its ID as TextView1. Now we will import some data in this TextView, TextView1. What is TextView1? Android Studio doesn't know anything like TextView1. What's that? It's wondering, what's that? So now, on create protected void, bundle saved instance of, we are writing TextView1, we're defining it like a definition. What is light and the definition? But transparent objects, these are objects from which light can pass through completely. Those are called transparent objects, like that. Here, it will be transparent objects and we are giving definition. Transparent objects is equal to what is transparent object, like that. Okay, private text view, text view one. What is text view one? We are giving the definition here. It's asking us, what is it? Text view one is equal to find view by ID. Here, you can see ID. So we are finding the view. View means something, some element in this design. Some element here, It can be text view, it can be button, it can be this linear layout too. So this text view, we are finding it by ID. Suppose my name is Anubrata, and they are finding that from this ID, that my name is Anubrata. Okay. TextView 1 is equal to find view by ID. Where is r.id? R, you can see your res, res. From that, that R, that capital R, we use this r.id. It is an ID. So r.id. Here we can get the ID of this only, of this activity main only, as you can see here. So set content view to r.layout.activity. We are getting all the information inside this design to this Java. So it's getting r.id.textview1. So now we have defined what is textview1. Now we can use like this. Textview1 that set on click listener. When we will click it, what will happen? You can type here new view.onclick listener. That's a code. You can save. Okay, that's a code. When TextView1 will be clicked, TextView.setOnClickListener, it will listen like that. When will it be clicked? When it will be clicked, it will pass the information to us. So this is the function. Public void. Void means function. OnClick. So when this will be clicked, new view.onClickListener is creating a new view.onClickListener. View means this text view. TextView.onClickListener. This OnClickListener will be, when it will be clicked, what will happen? OnClick. We don't need to worry about that, and what's will create it by itself. You just need to type textview1.setOnClickListener new view.onClickListener, and you have to press enter on the first choice, which shows second bracket dot 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 second bracket close. You have to click on that, and this thing will come. When it will be clicked, what will happen? TextView1.setText. We are setting its text to. You have to. We have to insert it into double quotes, and as it's a string, something which is a text, it is called a string. We are setting this text to a string with name, which name of string means the value of the string will be I am test. Okay, so click on save all, and now let's click on run. Installing. Launching the activity. And see, when I have clicked on this hello, I will show you from the beginning. From your, yeah, I think you can see now. I'll press that. You can see I am pressed. So that's working perfectly fine. So that's how we can put an element like text. We can change the background of, if we want, we can change this background to background. We can change the background color as well as the, we can create a gradient background. You know what's a gradient? From if you want to make a shade that from the darkest to lightest color, from dark orange to very light orange, we can create like that from left to right. That's an angle. We will learn that in afterward classes. So Android background. So what will be the background? Let's say black. Let's choose the background from here. Let's make it a light background like this. So here we will not put a color, we will just code it because we do not have to code it hundreds and thousands of lines. Here you can see it's done like that. The background is this color and the text view is of that color. So like this you can practice many things on Android Studio. So now let's create some projects on Android Studio. So now let's see. Let's create one integer and let me think of the project. So now we will not show I am pressed. Instead of when, it will just be like that. The background color will be black and there will be no text. Okay. And the gravity will not be center. Let me say, see if we can set the gravity. Yeah. I think we can't. Okay. So, let's set the text from here. Let's remove the text from here and we'll go and set the text there. We'll also change the background color. Let's set the background color to. And let's set the text to press me to get the text. Also, the let me see if the size can be done here. No. Achha, okay. So it will be like that. So now from here, when it will be clicked, it will show hello, I am Anubhata. It will change the background color and it will change the text as well. So let me see what was the background color. The background color was this, I think. Let me copy it. Let me make the changes again. Okay. So let's level C. And now we'll delete that one. Press, I am pressed. When it will be clicked, what will happen is that firstly, it will change its text color. TextView1.setColor. Set text color. What will be the color? This, I think. @color/my. So, let's get, let's fetch the text colors. Color code from here. Can be done. No, let's only change the text from here. Let's get these things back. Text color. My text color. Let's set this to this. Okay. Think. Okay, this was the background color. So only now what we will do when it will be pressed. Firstly, what we are going to do is we are going to change the text to hello, I am Anubhata. That's a great text we want. What we did the last one. So you need to practice like that again and again one project to learn it. Hello, I am Anubhata. Now let's learn a new thing. Here you can see something is yellow, which means something is not. So click on this bulb and click on this extract. String resource. Let's say, create one string from here, Anubhata. Let's name the string Anubhata. And let's click on OK. Here you can see r.string.anubhata. Go to string, you can see there's one string created named Anubhata. Hello, I am Anubhata. Here again, it's res.string, string inside the values.string.anubhata. It's not @string/, which is in the design. It will be r.string.anubhata. Which we have created inside it. So now, let me do it like that string. Let me, that's just for showing you string name. Just let's say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I think, no, only letters allowed. 1. And inside it will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. The text will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So now, we can do it like that. r.string.1. The text will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You can get it like that. So no need for this. While deleting this, you will notice that it turns gray. Means something is not correct. So we will change it back to Anubhata. r.string.anubhata. And let's see. I'm clicking what happens. Let's run it on our mobile. So it's not. Press me to get the text. Let's see if we press it, if you're able to see the screen. If you press it, hello, I'm Anubrata. I hope you'll be able to see that. When I pressed it, let me show you from the beginning again. Not this one. This app, yeah. You can see here the app, I think. Yeah. When I'm pressing on it, it shows, hello, I'm Anubrata. It's like, so it's working perfectly fine. So friends, that was all for today. Go to Advert Studio and go practice something awesome and make something awesome. And do share what you have made on the comment section. Just tell me what you have made. And then in the next classes, I will tell you how to create a button or something else like, let me see the components here. Buttons, rectangular view, image view, text view we did. Edit text and many things like speech, scroll view, fragment. You can see from text, plain text, password, password, numeric, email. We'll learn this in the upcoming classes. So friends, thank you for watching this video and please to share it with everyone. Also, if you are watching from YouTube, don't forget to subscribe to my channel. So we will see on next, we'll meet on next day. So till then, bye-bye.